Well, deciding what to do after graduation is still one of the toughest choices a person has to make. And for many, they end up finding jobs away from the farm or ranch where they grew up. But some instead do go back home and work with family. Cattlemen to Cattlemen reporter Kate Maher has more on a Virginia cattlewoman who was excited to return back to her roots.
In the beautiful Shenandoah Valley of Virginia, Margaret Ann Smith is out early in the morning feeding calves. Margaret Ann was born and raised in a beef-producing family, so it's no wonder she ended up with a career in agriculture.
I am the sixth generation at home, at our home place there. I farm with my dad and my brother, my grandmother, and my three-year-old nephew. When I left here to go to Kansas State in the late 90s, I probably never crossed my mind to ever think of anything else but coming back home. I've probably known that since I was a small child. This is what I always wanted to do, was come back home.
Once she graduated from college, Margaret Ann returned home and created Southlex Cattle Company, which works alongside her family's other cattle and farming operations. Southlex sources high-quality feeder cattle from the eastern and southeastern parts of the U.S. and sends them to customers across the country.
We have customers that vary literally from a cow-calf producer that is needing some extra cattle to supplement their own herd to finish out for their silage piles or whatever, that you know may only buy one tractor load a year. And then we've got guys that are running thousands upon thousands. Those cattle we ship into about 22 states, from New Hampshire to New Mexico. And it'll be anything from a little roping calf to a 900-pound cutting bull. And we're just filling orders for customers.
In addition to buying and selling cattle for her customers, Margaret Ann also runs her own backgrounding program, often buying high-risk cattle that require extra management and care.
We buy high-risk cattle because there's a lot of opportunity available with those cattle, and opportunity to upgrade those cattle, opportunity to improve on those cattle. Those cattle typically are, the genetics will be there, will have the genetic background, but they won't have the management component. So whether it might be a lax vaccination protocol, it may be an elderly person who doesn't have the ability or the infrastructure to do those things, but it's an opportunity for us to upgrade those cattle and make them to what the industry needs and wants and desires, and is more marketable by upgrading those cattle and pushing them forward.
Margaret Ann's passion for the beef industry is obvious, and she is a firm believer in the value of the beef checkoff. She's pleased with the checkoff's efforts over the years to educate consumers and build trust in both beef and those who produce it.
Those are things we as producers don't have the time to do, and that investment of a dollar a head is pennies compared to what it would take if we went and took our own time to try and educate consumers and stay in front of them. You know, the resources on the web that we provide through the checkoff are unbelievable. If you can't find it about beef, then it's all there because of our checkoff.
Knowing the importance of supporting the industry that supports her, Margaret Ann has also volunteered with several state and national ag organizations over the years. She's a longtime member of the National Cattlemen's Beef Association and appreciates the work NCBA does in Washington, D.C. on behalf of the beef industry.
And I can't run to D.C. every time we have an issue that needs to be approached. Even though we have great relationships with our state delegates and our state senators, and our, even our congressional delegation in D.C., we need those folks, boots on the ground every day, that are there advocating for us. It is truly a great organization. I know I'll always be a member.
In early 2020, at the start of the COVID-19 pandemic, Margaret Ann was one of the producer voices in a series of videos from NCBA called We're In This Together, aimed at helping provide some comfort and unity to farmers and ranchers during those uncertain times.
And I was very honored to be asked to kind of feature what we do with the livestock marketing and what we do here in Virginia. And that was a really cool opportunity to, you know, be a little, hopefully maybe a little bit of a bright spot about, you know, what was really trying times of, you know, we're all fighting for this and we're all trying to get forward and get through the other side.
At the end of the day, the most important thing for Margaret Ann is doing what she loves, caring for her cattle to produce beef.
I think we have an exciting future, especially when we see the things that we are the number one protein and we are preferred by consumers. We have to remember those are good things. Coming out of the chaotic year we've had, if we can still rank number one, there was at least one bright spot to this year. We must taste really, really good, and it's nice and comforting to know that beef is still preferred by consumers.
Reporting from Virginia, I'm Kate Maher for NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen.